So in this oversimplified, over-reductionistic cartoon, which I love for a number of reasons, we see a normal circuit shown on the left. And we know that when we're presented with any type of trauma or stress, even in normal circumstances, we get an activation of that circuit, as we would expect, as is physiologically relevant, proportional, and expected. What we see then is that when that emotional trauma is withdrawn, we have a circuit that returns to its basal level of activity. However, when we think about stress sensitization in these circuits, a very different picture evolves. So we see that normal circuit with a basal level of activity. We see emotional trauma leading to activation. However, with sustained, repeated emotional trauma, we see a persistent, continuously activated circuit. And unfortunately, for many of those kids, unlike Hansel and Gretel in our fairy tales, when that emotional trauma is withdrawn, there's been an irreversible sensitization. We can think of this as an inoculation of that circuit. Now, how do things progress from this point? Well, when we have the unprovoked, irreversible stress sensitization, that may not necessarily give rise to symptoms. We may have, if you will, a normal phenotype here. However, when that emotional trauma is reintroduced to that sensitized circuit, we may begin to see prodromal symptoms. And then over time, if the emotional trauma continues, we can have several scenarios. One is we can have further dysregulation of that circuit, which may produce still subsyndromal symptoms, not necessarily full syndromic post-traumatic stress disorder. However, in time, for a proportion of our kids, what we see is that even in the absence of that withdrawn trauma, we still have a decompensated circuit that probably results in persistent symptoms. Now let's think about this in terms of a risk diathesis model. So we know that under normal circumstances, when we have normal genes, and we can think about things like the serotonin transporter promoter polymorphism, and the individual is faced with any one of the various serpent stressors that we can encounter over the course of our lives, we essentially have a normal circuit and normal activation and a normal phenotype. Now, certainly there are situations where we do have a risk gene. And in those situations, when we're exposed to a particular stressor, we certainly have a biased circuit, and we may have some overactivation of that circuit, but we don't necessarily manifest in terms of post-traumatic stress symptoms. However, in a situation where we have a multiple hit scenario, wherein we have multiple genes that confer independent risk, and then we include various stressors in the face of this biased circuit, we can again end up with either a hypoactivated circuit or that unsuccessful compensation in the circuit, and that can give rise to these psychiatric symptoms.